of Matthew. Matthew 6:25. Let us read Matthew 6:25. And we are going to see what God has for us. Let us read together. Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what to eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. It is not life more important than food, and the body more important than clothes? Amen. Hallelujah. This is the word of the God. He's encouraging us not to worry. Amen. Because our God has good plans for us. Amen. He knows what we are going to eat, what we are going to wear. Although at times, we may worry because of how we are seeing the situation. Because at times, you can go to your cupboard and then you look at something to cook for your children, you get there's nothing to cook. Amen. And you begin to worry. But our God urges us not to worry because He has good plans for us. I've heard so many stories of people who did not worry in life, but God did for them. Amen. I've heard of people, of a woman who she relaxed. She had nothing to give to her children, but she relaxed. She waited upon the Lord, and the Lord surely provided unto her. Amen. The Lord provided unto her. I remember the story that goes that the woman prepared some water. Amen. Amen. When she prepared some water, the girl, her daughter was asking, "Mom, there's no flour. What are you going to cook because we are boiling the water?" But the mom told her, "No, just take the water, go and bathe." Amen. And the girl did as the instruction of the mother. She took the water and went to bathe. Amen. And when she came back, the mother had put another water. Amen. And the girl asked, "No, mom, you have put another water. What are you going to cook because it's no flour?" But the mom said, "Just relax." Amen. And God in this, God was doing something. Amen. She had prepared another woman to pray for her flour. Amen.
Amen.
At that point, she had a knock at the door. And coming in was a lady with a packed bag full of everything that they could need. Amen. Amen. And the girl was amazed. Amen.
Amen.
So God knows us. He knows us. Amen.
Amen.
In connection with this, there's one thing that we can do to avoid this. Amen.
Amen.
And this is prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Lack of prayers at times causes us to worry. Amen. Lack of prayers causes us to do things that we could not have done. Amen. Like the anger. Amen. So we are urged that we should pray. We should pray because the word of God tells us that we should not cease to pray. We should pray in the morning, in the afternoon, and in the evening. Amen.
Amen.
So we should pray all the time. Amen.
Yeah.
And also have fellowship. Have fellowship with one another. Amen.
Amen.
I may be down at this time. And when I have come into the house of God and have fellowship with the people of God, I'm lifted up. Amen. My spirit is lifted up. Amen.
Amen.
And to avoid all the mess that could bring us, so we are supposed to avoid the emotional sickness, spiritual sickness, and even physical. And just remaining there, you are just there. Amen.
Amen.
And so that you can be cured. Amen.
Amen.
And the remedy of this cure is seeking the God. Amen. Seeking our Father. Amen. Praying all the time, studying the Word of God, and also testifying. Amen.
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 It's good to testify. Although at times we just see that something small, but it's good to testify because we are told by the Word of God through the testimony of the God people, things work. Amen.
Amen.
Things work. Amen. And so we should learn to testify. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me say I'm blessed by this word this morning. Because this word is not my word, it's the word of God.
Amen.
And also, I got it from somebody else, amen.
Amen.
A person that I respect so much, amen.
Amen.
And this is Her Excellence Rachel Ruto, amen.
Amen.
This was her word when we were in the conference, amen.
Amen.
And so, this word also bless you, as it blessed us when you were there, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be blessed. Wow, we are blessed. But we thank God for everything. I thank God because of that word hearing. And remember, we have a healer, Jesus Christ. He's our healer. And our life will never remain the same again. Can you say that? Because you have a healer today.
My life
will never remain the same again.
Amen.
We are fully part. The one who gave us that word We are so blessed.
Amen.
None other, like, let's show me through. We have a prayer of a woman in the authority.
Amen.
And we are going fast.
Amen.
So, I want to invite the daddy preacher, the lady I know for a long time. She has been a blessing to me. Now, we have worked together in this sanctuary, up and down. Now, we have seen God together. And she happened to be my roommate when I was there. And she took care of me.
Amen.
So I want to invite my sister. She has a word. None other than Elizabeth Maina.
Amen.
My sister. Hallelujah. Hey, how are you?
We are fine.
Praise God.
Amen.
Can you leave in where we please? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, I am a king.
I am a king.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, your majesty. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
The time had gone to Nakuru. I'm telling you. Those girls, ladies or girls who missed. You missed something. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
It was wonderful. I'm Elizabeth Maina. I'm born again. I love Jesus Christ and my personal Savior. He has been my God and my Savior. I've walked with Him. I've seen Him in my life. And I've no regret of knowing this Jesus. Born as if you are. It's a good God. Yeah. Who are not saved? Just try to test Him. Eh? Yeah. Oh, yes. I would do an inclusion. Born as if you are. Now, go straight to the word. Now, my topic of the word today. And your expectation shall not be part of. Maybe you can give it that title. Bwana asifiwe. Your expectation shall not be cut off. Let's see the book of Proverbs 23:18. Put it on the screen. Proverbs 23:18. We read together. There is surely, you read all of you. Surely, future hope for you, and your hope will not be cut off. Bwana asifiwe. My dear, put it in KGV. For sure, there is an end, and that expectation cannot be cut off. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, there is hope, there is future for you. And your expectation shall not be cut off. One as it were. What is your expectation? What is your expectation, my dear brother? What is your expectation, my sister? Do you have any expectation? Do you need anything from God?
Yes.
Can you hold on it?
Yes.
Can you trust that God? God, my expectation cannot be cut off. Can you say that, all of you?
My expectation
cannot be cut off. I can't hear you.
My expectation.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Maybe you have a problem. Now children are going back to school. Now that the song is big. Children are going back to school. I have no school fees. I don't know where the money will come from. My dear, your expectation shall not be part of. What does it do? Maybe you say, my husband is not assisting me. Your husband is not God.
Amen.
Yeah, you have God. You have a big God yourself, a king, a king of kings. Why not this way? Don't expect to get school fees from your husband.
Yes.
Sisters, can you say amen?
Amen.
Because maybe some husband, some wives, they say that their husband are not supporting them. Why not this way?
Amen.
But it is God in heaven.
Amen.
There is God in heaven.
Yes.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
There is God in heaven.
Yes.
We have women, those who don't have husband. True or false?
True.
Where do they get their money?
From God.
From God.
Amen.
You wives. Those who have husband, let me tell you one thing. If you have put expectation to man, he'll fail you. Husbands are good. I'm not saying husband you are bad. You are good, and it's good to have a husband.
Amen.
And there's something good. That's what God created.
elevated man. And after that, he said, let me get a helper. And the helper is the pastor to Margaret. And a helper is somebody to touch somebody. What are they doing? That's what I'm saying. They are not good. I'm sick of it. You know, sometimes I say, that lady was preaching about husband. That attacked her bed with her husband. I love, they are good. They are our head. But ladies, no, you are the neck. And the neck can turn. The head is under here. But the neck can tell you, can you turn up? Can you do this? Can you do this? But the head is there. It's a person in the heart. The neck, what does it do? God is good all the time. What does it do? Let me tell you, my dear brothers and sisters, there's something good. God is going to be in this house of worship and healing. I am going to Kabarak. Kabarak is a good place. Did you have a beer? Let me tell you, you cannot touch territory of Kabarak. You know how you step in that ground of Kabarak, our Bishop Mark declared that it is Christ born at his way. And from that moment, everyone, any minister who was standing there to preach the gospel, there was anointing. Huh? Another lady called Dada Anderson. She came all the way from America. Huh? And she was telling, it's over 300, she said 300 or 400, 700 miles to come and spread the good news of the kingdom. Imagine, and her sister Tuya, maybe you said, I don't feel like going. Huh? Even as the mark of a complex, staying outside from the family, my husband, huh? Adore your husband, adore your family. But remember one thing, without God, we are going nothing. We are going nowhere. What are you doing? Tell God. My expectation? Hallelujah. Let's see the book.